tired of being broke, you need to flip or buy and hold. Clocking in and out, your 9 to 5 is getting old. JD booming, AC cash, they known to get the bag. You can make your own schedule, know you liking that. Time to take the next step, take your money, invest. Know you just got that check, go sign up with JTech. Yeah.
Fellas.
Yeah.
Hey, it's 2021.
It is.
But I know you're wondering.
What was it?
Man, if we went back 10, 20, 30 years, what would it be? We're going to jump in that time machine.
Man,
we're going to go back in the way back time machine. And we're going to see what we would tell our 21-year-old self.
Our 21-year-old self?
21-year-old self.
Oh, that was
you scared? You scared?
No, I was enjoying myself.
Okay.
We're going to cover it. That's a bad dude.
Paperboy and Festus. Stick around. Hi, I'm AC Cash, and this is
Jay the Technician,
and this is
JD Boom.
We're here on behalf of Pivot Point Investors, where we help the average investor grow his nest egg. And when we're talking about nest eggs, fellas, I guess if we had to go back in the time machine, let's go back in the time machine.
We gonna get at it and go back.
We're going back.
Oh, yeah.
Now we're 20, 30 years ago.
Ooh.
What would we tell our 21-year-old self? That's what I want to know. I was wondering.
Oh, man, y'all got to let me go first with this one, man. Y'all got to, right, man. Because then I'm back in 1998, man.
Okay,
I'm in 98. I don't even remember the music from 98 and stuff. But I will tell you this.
Uh-huh.
I was at Morehouse College.
All right.
In my economics class, my economics teacher said, "Hey, gentlemen, got this new company that I want to introduce to the class called Amazon."
Amazon? Dr. Whomever, you crazy.
Man, listen, I would give his name, but I ain't gonna do that, right?
Doctor, you
so
crazy.
He didn't give me permission to do that, so
okay.
I ain't gonna do it.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, if you go back and research it, the IPO for Amazon dropped in 1997.
Okay.
So it was out there. He had made about $25,000 by the time he brought it to us.
Okay.
Because we was always asking about new stocks and what he thought, man. Mm-hmm. So he's like, "Hey, Judge, you need to really look at this." He said, "I don't care if you gotta go to your parents, borrow it, work for it. You take student loan, you get a refund check.
Okay.
Hey, try to put you about $5,000 in."
$5,000 back then, okay.
Now,
he was telling you, come with the house, bet that thing, right?
Now, so many, out of all the companies I could have got,
right,
I get one of the top growth companies of all time.
Okay.
The first $1 trillion company.
Right.
Right. Mm-hmm. That dude tell me to invest $5,000.
Yeah,
and as a college student, I had it because I inherited some money.
You were spending that student loan money. That's what
Hey, I inherited some money. Yeah, it was a death in the family. I inherited some money.
Okay.
And so I had no excuse.
Yeah.
There was no reason not to do that.
Well, fear was your reason not
fear,
to.
Fear, and I thought I was, man, ain't nobody going to buy stationery and books and magazines.
Online.
It was like,
yeah.
Get out of here, man. Go
okay.
I thought I knew more.
Okay.
And that cute.
And I guess that $5,000 would have grown.
Man, $5,000, it's depressing to even think about it.
Yeah.
$5,000, never touched it, never taken out.
Mm-hmm.
Roughly about $19 million.
$19 million, that's give or take a
give
million.
Give or take a million.
All right.
Depending on if it's an update,
right.
It'll be 22.
Hey, you win a few, you lose a few.
That was a big loss, right?
Hey, that's not right. Okay, well, we'll let you rest in that misery for a little while. Technician, I know your 21-year-old self, going back into that way back time machine,
woo.
I know, you're thinking, man, if I just did what?
I would personally say I should have bought more houses. At the time, I had money and I was jumping from home to home.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a lot of family members like, "Oh, I know you're doing great.
You can
flip these houses or we can do rental properties." I'm like, "No, I just wanna go from one house to a bigger house to a bigger house." And once I got tired of them or tired of the area I left, that was one of the biggest regrets to me, is that I did not hold on to my home. I kept letting them go for that short-term flip, but didn't see that long-term.
Okay, he's playing with Cash Arena when you're talking that action.
Yeah.
So the man says he regrets letting them go.
Yeah,
I hear you. Well, you've been reading in my playbook. I had to get that guy on my playbook. Because AC Cash is going to tell you something.
Yeah, what you got?
My 21-year-old self, I wouldn't have sold a piece of property anywhere. Wouldn't have sold it. I wouldn't have sold it. I was acquiring property, but I was getting rid of property, you know, all that flipping razzle dazzle.
Yeah.
And literally just, let's go three examples.
All right.
You know, I cover this in my real estate course. I talk about it.
Okay.
Biggest deal was the first duplex I ever got into for $55,000.
Mm-hmm.
That property, it was probably worth $65,000, $75,000. It wasn't a big deal,
yeah.
But it was enough years ago that appreciation over time,
mm-hmm.
just holding that property instead of getting that short-term money, mm-hmm. is worth at least $450,000 today.
Oh.
$450,000. And that's covering the note, that's giving cash flow every month. That's one property.
Okay.
If I flop down in my mind.
That's
my
the 80s and 90s.
Hey man, don't go in years and stuff, man.
Okay.
That is that is late 80s.
Late
80s, 89 or so, okay. You know.
1989, another.
I hear you, you dig yourself there. Okay, so that's one property. That's one that with a cash flow itself, close your eyes every month, it's paying you, and it's steadily appreciated. And you know, if you know Atlanta, it was in Grant Park.
Oof.
Grant Park, great area for appreciation. You know it today as you look back in time, but it was just a regular good area back then. But if you have enough people who've been down that path, they tell you definitively, hey young blood, 10 years from now, 20 years from now,
that's right.
You want to hold on because it's going to do its thing.
Right.
3 years, 5 years, 10 years, mm-hmm. 3%, 5% per year, man, that's $500,000 a day.
That's funny.
Another property I'm going to fly down in my mind with two properties in Miami. Miami, I bought a home, it was about $83,000. I thought I overpaid.
Mm-hmm.
Overpaid, and the family living there, $83,000. I'm like, man, I probably overpaid. You know, I didn't haggle enough. I didn't do my thing. It was in, what's it called? Miami Gardens. No, not Miami Gardens. I'll get the name, I'll think about it. But, I mean, it was just such a regular bread and butter corner lot, house, four bed, two bath, it's doing its thing. You get a little extra on top of it. That house today is at least $550,000. At least.
Good.
And that was in the 90s, you know. Mm. In the 90s, didn't have to do anything to it.
Right,
it just
right.
did its thing, nothing special. Let's see, a third one in Miami, it was a five-unit building. No big deal.
Mm.
You know, you gotta board up the holes because rats were getting
oh.
there. I had tenants from hell. That was a problem. You know, they were growing chickens. They had chickens in the yard and they wouldn't let them get away. They put a hole in the bottom of the floor so they could feed the chickens that were hidden
wow.
under the house.
What?
Yeah, it was a whole big thing. And so,
wow.
you know, I'm in it for under $200,000. Right now, that property, and that was the late 90s, early 2000s, holding it through. And that property is easily worth $700,000 a day. Easily worth $700,000 a day. Of course, there's no chickens there.
Yeah.
It kicked out
yeah.
bad folks and all that. But in 2008, when everything went crazy, hey, it was like rats on a ship. All of us were jumping out of some of those properties that we had that we didn't think. My property management company closed during that time.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't tell us for 2 months.
Ooh.
They were just gone. We couldn't reach them in Miami. They were out of the business. It was chaos.
Mm.
And so you get what you can and keep moving. But my 21-year-old self,
yeah.
you know,
yeah.
you just, I was a little 21, of course. Mm. But that example is a property that today, gorgeous property.
Wow.
In the same place, same, but the area has gone up.
Right.
Downtown has moved toward that area mm. where it is in Miami. And, you know, I would look like a genius on that one alone. And so that's a five-unit place. I probably got three or four more I could say that should have never gone anywhere. Although, when everybody was jumping ship, there's a strong inclination to jump ship too
right.
to save yourself.
But right. you know, that makes a lot of sense though, Cash. Mm-hmm. But another thing that I had to remember it happened in the 90s that was real big is most of us fellow brothers, man, we was flossing that gold.
goal.
You lost that goal hard.
I have a gold.
Man, you got that gold chain on right now, though. You had that gold.
The gold I have is the one I had for over 30 years. Okay. Same chain.
A lot of cats had that gold chain, and all of a sudden, you know, the industry came out and said, platinum's the new thing.
Okay,
and switched that. A lot of brothers gave up that gold. And I remember a guy coming to us, man, saying, man, y'all don't know, man, that gold stands the test of time.
Yeah.
And I know a lot of brothers, man, including myself, probably eating ourselves, man, for getting rid of all that gold. Because now that gold.
He still love gold.
Yeah, he still love gold.
Hold on, man. I tell you, I'm gold forever, man. Because, you know, during that time in the 90s, gold at that point was only $160 an ounce, man. Gold right now is sitting at almost $2,000 an ounce.
Yeah, so I see why you like gold.
So, I mean,
so you miss, so gold is through, one you
through,
miss.
Through time, man, gold.
So giving up the gold is something that hits you. You wish you couldn't have, you would have done.
The guy with the rock.
Man, well, I mean, you said Amazon shit. I'd have said Apple. When that iPhone came out, I don't know why did I think that that was the most revolutionary thing on the planet. I should have gave my whole soul on that thing.
Yeah, I was told Apple.
It was the baddest thing ever. I mean, it was the first smartphone ever. We've never seen nothing like it. And
okay.
I just got caught up in being the user. I didn't think about
the company behind it.
The flow of money.
And I guess that's the moral of the story. We every day. People are using things. Everyone watching this is using products. They're using services. They're using all sorts of things that they never think, can I own it? Just that little piece of it.
Yeah.
A couple hundred shares, 10 shares, 20, 100, 500. That's still a fraction of those millions of shares out there. But the amount of growth that time will allow for it, we're not thinking of that.
That's right.
So we're telling them to look at our way back time machine and look at these opportunities that were sitting there cheap back then, and you don't exploit them. That's why you have to listen to trusted sources who can tell you, young blood, don't do what I did.
Oh yeah. Listen, we got so many examples. This has got to be a series. Because we go through too much, then y'all will get lost and bored. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe it'll be entertaining laughing at us and our pain.
I know.
But I'll say this will be a series. We'll come with more. And if you got some suggestions, send them in to us. Add them into the comments. What would you like to hear about?
Comments. I know they're subscribed.
Hey,
you're subscribed. You already subscribed. Okay, we know they're subscribed.
And
okay.
The next thing is share it,
share it with a friend.
Throwing it out there.
Friends give good information to friends.
They do.
That's if we listen, though. We didn't listen.
We didn't listen, but, you know, you're right.
Yeah, we didn't listen.
We didn't listen. We are part of the problem.
You know, the friends was like, hey, I got an idea for you. You're like,
no. Hey, one thing about it, if you live long enough, you're going to make mistakes.
That's right.
Now, you want to look at enough people who've made those mistakes and then avoid them.
That's right.
That's a good way to go about things.
That's right.
But you have to have a trusted source, because there's a lot of people just spitting out crazy information.
Yeah. Or regurgitating stuff they heard. Yep. They did no research on it.
Yep.
Like, how do you know that that is factual?
Because I remember my buddy at Morehouse, he was like, man, got to get some of this Eastern stock. Eastern Airlines.
Oh, wow.
It was like Eastern Airlines. Now, we're both from Miami, so Hub was in, for Eastern, was in Miami.
Oh.
So, you know, we were like, hey, man, get that Eastern Star. And I was like, no, I'm not messing with it.
Mm.
It wasn't 6 months later. Man.
Out of there.
Ooh. So,
and I remember Eastern
Star. That's right. So, all advice isn't good advice.
That's right.
So, you have to get it from trusted sources. Yeah. This was just another guy.
So, then we setting up the show of what's the worst advice you ever took?
Worst advice you ever took. My God.
Oh, okay.
That's going to be a tough one.
Oh, we got to have it.
That's going to be a tough one. So, we'll talk about that one.
Yeah.
I'm sure you've taken some bad advice before.
Rest in peace, American Online.
AOL.
AOL, baby. Hey. Well, let's save it for that show, man.
I thought that was going to be the baby, man. I loved it. First thing, the crazy internet, man.
You got all those discs in the mail.
Yeah,
you know, free trials, man. All those doggone
30-day free trials, man. Yeah. I mean, they were good, though.
Yeah, there's a lot of that, and that's where the trust factor. You gotta trust. Look at the history that the person has, or the business, or whoever's giving you that information.
That's right.
You know, if it's not a proven track record, let them go.
That's right.
Because you're going to get a lot of information. Keep living, you'll get a lot of information.
Yeah, absolutely.
We went to this way back time machine.
We
looked and said, hey, let's take a quick peek at the ways that, what would we tell ourselves? What would we say, hey, Mr. Boom, don't do that. Hey, Boom, do this.
Right.
And
but we probably had to put a straight jacket on that joker because he was just feeling this.
That young Boom.
Young Boom, you know, Magic City Boom.
Not Magic City Boom.
Okay. It was Boom.
Okay, all right. But Boom,
so Boom was Coogi sweaters. Right. And, you know, like. Boom. Iceberg.
Okay. Yeah, little Boom wasn't quite listening to
brand new
much
Jeep
advice.
Grand Cherokee. Oh, you know, at that point, like
he was riding his Jeep with his chains.
Yeah.
Oh man, crazy.
So yeah.
All right, rest in peace to the old Boom.
Yes, Lord. Thank you. Get out of there.
There you go.
Yeah.
So, hey, guys, we just want you to understand that we've all been through times when we said, I should have. It's a bunch of you Dogecoins, and man, on the shouldn't have done and should have done, we can talk about your Dogecoin buddy doing some investing in that when he missed the peak. That was a whole conversation.
Absolutely.
So, we'll dive into that, but we appreciate everybody sharing in this way back time machine.
Way back.
Now, how are we going to get back to the present? We got to figure that out.
Got to get back in there.
Okay, got to figure it out.
Hit the button, man.
In the DeLorean.
That's right.
Well, there's a lot of people invested in DeLorean.
Back then, because of the movie, that's right.
Yeah, man, right. That was foolish.
It turned out to be.
That's a whole other story, John DeLorean.
Yeah.
Okay, we're not messing with that. Hey. We're Pivot Point Investors. We want you to stay smart. We want you to learn from our mistakes and then learn from our present actions that are moving forward. So that's in real estate, stock investment. We want you to even crypto.
Absolutely.
We want you to stay informed. Guys, we're going to put a pin because we're going to come back to this and look at the next one.
That's right.
Y'all good?
Good.
Hey, on behalf of Pivot Point Investors, I'm AC Cash. This is
J the Technician.
And this is
JD.
Trying to help you not make the mistakes of the past. Keep investing. Stay smart, guys.